Hello everyone, in this video we're gonna see the main idea on how to create this waterfall double exposures that you can see in here using Adobe Photoshop. But before we're gonna do that, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. Alright, so let's get to it. Alright, so let's go and open Photoshop, and then let's go and open the image I will be using. And by the way, you can use this method with other waterfalls. As you can see in here, I create a mini double exposure using waterfalls, and it doesn't have to be the same image of the waterfall. You can use it with another image. I will make sure to put in the description some other waterfalls that you can use maybe in your photos. But anyway, for this tutorial we're gonna try with this image in here. So we'll go and open the main model. Alright, so the first thing that we have to do is to make a selection. So we'll go and select object selection and then select subject. Alright, now we have a selection, but still I'm gonna go to select and mask, because I'm sure if I zoom in you will see in the edges it's not that smooth. I mean, it have some fringes, but it's okay in this case because we're gonna use this as a double exposure, so that will work. But I think I want to make it a little bit smoother in the edge, and to do that you can just go to the global refinement, and in the smooth in here I will exaggerate it. I'm gonna put 90, and then I'm gonna wait for it to process. All right as you can see, we have a very smooth edge, and that's exactly what I wanted. Now we'll go further and maybe put up the contrast to like 20%, and again I will wait for it to process. All right I think it looks good. All right so I'm happy with this, so I'm just gonna press OK, and then I'm gonna apply it as a layer mask. All right next I will go to the crop tool, and I'm gonna make this wider, almost like a square. Yeah, something like that. And after that I'm gonna press Ctrl Command T, and I'm gonna make the model fit with the new size that we have in here. All right I think it looks good. All right next we need to create a background, so we'll go to adjustment and choose solid color, and let's choose like a soft gray, and I'm gonna put it below the model, and let's delete this layer mask and name this BG and the model. Alright, now I want actually to put down the brightness of the model a little bit, so I will go and apply a brightness and contrast. I will clip it to the model, and after that I'm gonna put down the brightness -100, and for the contrast I'm gonna put it like 40 or 50, yeah something like this. I think it will work. Now I want to actually to change this to black and white in the end, but for now I think we are doing very good. Now the secret of having a really nice double exposure is to have a clear separation between the background and the subject, and that's the key to have a really nice one. So that's what we did in this one in here. Alright so we'll go and open the waterfall that we'll be using. I'm just gonna place it. Maybe I will change the blending mode already to lighten, and after that I'm gonna press Ctrl Command T again, and I think I want the waterfall to be just right here. Alright now I like that the ear in here is showing a little bit from this side, and I want to hide a little bit of the eye, just like that. Alright maybe a little bit more smaller, yeah perfect. I think somewhere around here it will work very good. Now as you can see we have a really nice one with colors, but for this one I really don't like the color, so I'm just gonna go and apply black and white adjustment. Alright I think it looks really cool like that. After that I will change the background to match the same color that we have in the head in here. So because we have a solid color, I can just double click on this color in here, and then sample whatever color I want, as you can see. And now, as you can see, it will blend much better. Maybe a little bit more, let's see. I think something like that, it would work really cool. Now, as you can see, because we don't have a layer mask on the waterfall image, you can see this one in here. We can fix that by applying a layer mask and using a brush with black as a foreground. You can just go and delete all this that I don't want. Make sure that you don't delete from the part of the model. Just like that. Alright, now let's go and put the birds. This one. Can I make it a little bit bigger? And maybe place them just right here. Yeah, something like that. I think it will look interesting. Alright, now I'm gonna apply a layer mask on the birds and using the same brush. I will delete actually a little bit from the bird to make them faded with the background. And the same goes for this. And also this one in here. Yeah, something like that. I think it looks really cool. Alright, the next thing that I want to do is actually to delete some of the details that we have on the model in here. Especially in the eye. Yeah, something like that. Maybe I will put down the flow to 1% with 100% opacity. And I'm gonna start deleting from the parts that I don't want them to be shown in here. Yeah, I think it looks really interesting. Now, the other thing that I want to do is actually to make the waterfall like to appear more white. So to do that, I will go to the adjustment layer of the black and white, and then I'm gonna apply a level adjustment. And from here, maybe I will just play with the black and the white points in here. That will make everything fade, so it's better to play with the midtones. Yeah, something like that. I think it looks interesting. Yeah, I really like this part in here of the white. So I think this is really cool. Now, I don't want this to be applied on the whole image. So I'm gonna try the blend if option if it's gonna work for this one. So I will go and open the blending options. And in the blend if, in the underline layer, I will split this black point by pressing Alt or Option and holding it. And this will allow me to split it. And as you can see, the more I go, the more the black will fade or the gray point will fade in here. But still, it looks a little bit strong, but it's okay, we can apply this. So, and the other thing that you can do is to actually invert the layer mask of the level by pressing Ctrl Command I, and this will invert it to black, and using the same brush, but this time we need white as a foreground color, we're gonna start painting only in the areas that we want. Now, the other thing that I want to do is actually to make a copy of the waterfall that we have in here. So I'm just gonna select it, and then I will press Ctrl Command J, and this will create a copy, and I will place it above the background adjustment that we have. And then I'm gonna delete this layer mask, and I'm gonna put back the blending mode to normal. After that, I'm gonna press Ctrl Command T, and I'm gonna make this really big until I only see the waterfall, just like that. All right, I think this will work. Now I'm gonna change the blending mode of these to soft light. And I'm gonna put down the opacity to like 50%, just to have that texture in the back of the image. Now we'll go back to the original waterfall in here, and I will delete a little bit from this side in here, just to have it blend perfectly. Alright, so the last thing that I want to do is to apply another adjustment. So we'll go and choose levels again. And this time I'm gonna play with the RGB. So we'll go and choose the red. And using this black and white point in here, I can add a little bit of red to the image. and a little bit of cyan. Let's see. Maybe a little bit more red. Less cyan. Then I will go to the blue. And I will add a little bit of blue. With a little bit of yellow. After that, I will go back to the RGB. And I will play with the midtones in here. And also the points. Now I'm gonna put down the opacity to 0 and I will go a little bit up, like 35%. Now you can add as many adjustments as you want, but for me I think I will add just one more. So I will go and choose exposure and I'm gonna play with the exposures a little bit. Maybe not that much, just like that. And let's play with the offsets. Yeah, something like that. I think it looks really interesting. And maybe I will put down the opacity to like 70%. Alright, I think it looks really cool. Now, one thing that it's actually don't like is to have this a little bit like this. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create a new layer on top. And then I will go to the gradient. And using linear style with the color to transparent, I will actually sample the color that we have in here, and I will go outside of the canvas, and I will one click and drop up just like that, and another one just like this. All right, I think it looks really cool like that. Maybe try different blending mode, maybe multiply, maybe leave it just like this, and I will do the same for the upper part. We'll go outside the canvas and I will one click and drag just like that. And let's change the blending mode to multiply. I think multiply will work. And then I'm gonna drop down the opacity a little bit. Alright, I think it looks really cool. And that will be our video. So I hope that you enjoy and you like this tutorial and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment and you know wait for more to come, and have a nice day. Thank you for watching.